Last night's Democratic presidential debate in Las Vegas was the most contentious matchup yet for the party's leading contenders. As Amna Nawaz reports, it all came at a critical moment in the campaign, with early voting underway in a dozen states and just days to go before the start of the Nevada caucuses.
So how was your night last night?
Michael Bloomberg campaigning today in Utah, just hours after his first Democratic debate appearance in Las Vegas, where he was the center of his rivals' attention.
I think it's great you got a lot of money, but I think you've got to come forward with your tax returns.
The billionaire businessman entered the race just 3 months ago, but his opponents made up for lost time, sharply challenging Bloomberg's record as a three-term mayor of New York City.
Mr. Bloomberg had policies in New York City of stop and frisk, which went after African-American and Latino people in an outrageous way.
If I go back and look at my time in office, the one thing that I'm really worried about, embarrassed about, was how it turned out with stop and frisk.
It's not whether he apologized or not, it's the policy. The policy was abhorrent.
Massachusetts Senator Elizabeth Warren repeatedly questioned Bloomberg on allegations his company covered up reports of sexual misconduct.
So, Mr. Mayor, are you willing to release all of those women from those non-disclosure agreements so we can hear their side of the story?
We have a very few non-disclosure agreements.
How many is that?
Let me finish.
How many is that?
None of them accused me of doing anything other than maybe they didn't like the joke I told. And there's agreements between two parties that wanted to keep it quiet, and that's up to them. They signed those agreements, and we'll live with it.
Warren continued her attacks at a campaign stop today.
It was my job to make sure that America got a little closer look at Mayor Bloomberg and came to understand that of all the people standing on that stage, he is the riskiest one for the Democrats.
Last night, others like Vermont Senator Bernie Sanders confronted Bloomberg on his estimated $60 billion personal fortune.
Mike Bloomberg owns more wealth than the bottom 125 million Americans. That's wrong. That's immoral.
Bloomberg, a Republican-turned-Democrat who's running as a moderate alternative to Sanders, pushed back.
What a wonderful country we have. The best-known socialist in the country happens to be a millionaire with three houses. What'd I miss here?
Sanders and Bloomberg are leading the field in the most recent PBS NewsHour NPR Marist poll, but both were accused by former South Bend, Indiana Mayor Pete Buttigieg of being too polarizing to win.
Let's put forward somebody who's actually a Democrat. Look, we shouldn't have to choose between one candidate who wants to burn this party down and another candidate who wants to buy this party out.
Wednesday's debate was one of the last chances for trailing candidates to break through before Super Tuesday on March 3rd, when a third of all Democratic delegates are up for grabs.
I'm the only one on this stage that actually got anything done on health care.
Debate battle lines were drawn once again on health care.
It's not a plan, it's a PowerPoint. And Amy's plan is even less. It's like a post-it note, insert plan here.
And on immigration, of particular interest in Nevada, where Latinos make up one in every five Democratic voters. Here's Mayor Buttigieg addressing Senator Klobuchar.
If you're going to run based on your record of voting in Washington, then you have to own those votes, especially when it comes to immigration.
I wish everyone was as perfect as you, Pete. You've memorized a bunch of talking points and a bunch of things, but I can tell you one thing. What the people of this country want, they want a leader that has the heart for the immigrants of this country, and that is me.
At the end of a bruising night, a clear sign that no one is ready yet to hang up their gloves.
Yes or no, leading person with the delegate, should they be the nominee or not?
No, let the process work its way out.
If no candidate has the majority of delegates by convention time in July, only Sanders said the delegate leader should become the nominee.
After trading brutal blows in last night's debate, some of the candidates are back out today, working the crowds, fighting for those last-minute caucus commitments, like Senator Elizabeth Warren here. The Democratic candidates will face off again in another debate next Tuesday in South Carolina.